Good morning, AHS, and welcome to AHS News. I'm Chase.
And I'm Liam. Today's Tuesday, November 28th. The pep rally was held last week in the AHS Fieldhouse. Let's see some highlights of the event.
He's one of the most well-known people in school, but how well do you really know him? This is the real Mr. Darlington.
Who are you?
Mr. Darlington.
Mr. Darlington, why do you do what you do?
I do what I do because I enjoy working with students, teachers, and parents so that kids can turn into young adults.
That's awesome. So I actually have a gift for you. I have a shirt for you. It says, "Lunch is my favorite subject." Tell us about your happy place.
Lunch duty is one of my favorite places to be. I call it my classroom because as assistant principals, we don't have classrooms. So I do like lunch. There's 400 people there. There's every type of person, every type of situation going on, and every type of food. So those are some of my favorite things all together.
That's awesome. This is for you, by the way.
All right. Did I tell you that or did you talk to someone else?
Well, you're Mr. Darlington. We have to know. Would you say that your love of sports also motivates you for what you do for a living? I mean, what can you say about this? Thursdays are for soccer.
That's right. I like to play soccer. We play on Thursday nights with some of the coaches from other schools in the Merrimack Valley. And Thursdays are great.
Awesome. So would you say your love of movies also motivates what you do? I mean, you went to film school. Tell us about film school.
That's correct. I enjoy some of the classic movies like The Godfather, Apocalypse Now is one of my favorite movies. So that's definitely something that has interested me. And I taught TV production for 18 years, so I really enjoyed doing what Mr. Brennan does.
That's awesome. So finally, what do you want the world to know about Mr. Darlington?
I want the world to know that I'm very thankful for Andover TV and the news show because they bring our community closer together by sharing with us, all of us, what the rest of us do.
Awesome, and doot doot a loot doot.
Doot doot.
Last week, the Drama Guild put up their production of Rent. Let's see some of the highlights.
AHS's new musical, Rent, debuted this past weekend in the Collins Center. It tells the story of a group of impoverished young people struggling to create a life in Lower Manhattan. Let's hear from the Drama Guild and fans about this new musical. What is your role in the Drama Guild?
I'm currently the co-president of the Drama Guild, and I'm also Joanne in Rent.
Nice. And
expect to tear up, because a lot of people have done so at rehearsals already, me included. Expect to have a ton of fun, because this is a very fun musical.
Great. Thank you so much. Who am I here with?
Anat Briskin.
Eva Liss.
Sydney Blanchett.
And what are your roles for the upcoming musical?
I set designed, and I'm also going to be on the run crew.
I'm acting.
I'm a stage manager.
All right, and what should the audience expect coming into Rent?
A lot of fun, hopefully a good set.
Yeah, there's a lot of rock music, so be prepared.
It's a very emotional musical, and it means a lot to all the actors.
How excited are we for the musical this weekend?
I'm so fired up. I'll be there for sure.
I'm beyond fired up. It's going to be a great show. Can't wait.
Excited to, you know, step out of my comfort zone and, yeah, explore new interests.
Definitely. I'll see you guys at Rent. Thank you.
Yep. Yes, sir.
How was the production of Rent overall?
I think it went pretty well. We got judged on our two closing nights by people for, like, we're entering a competition. So at the end of the school year, we'll get, like, notes back on how we did. And a couple people might be nominated for, like, awards. In general, I think the show went pretty well.
And what was your experience with the Drama Guild overall?
I think that I found... Honestly, like, I got closer with the people in this show than I ever have in any other show, and I really appreciate all the people in the Drama Guild. They're all really welcoming, and in general, I just really enjoyed my experience with them.
My father.
Do you want to dance?
With you.
But my students would rather watch TV.
America.
America.
You're sensitive as feet. Brush the sauce on to the meat. You can make the menu sparkle with rhyme.
Hello? Dad, yes, I beeped you. Maureen is coming to Mother's hearing. We're okay.
Thanksgiving may be over, but it's still the season of gratitude. What are you thankful for, HS?
What are you guys gonna be doing for Thanksgiving?
I'm gonna be going over to my grandma's house, eating good.
I'm gonna just have a nice dinner with my family and maybe ski a little bit.
Have a nice day with my family, having cousins over from Philadelphia, and yeah, probably going skiing a bit.
Just hang out with the family, and season 8's coming out on Fortnite. We gotta grind.
Yeah. Hey, what are you thankful for Thanksgiving this year?
I'm most thankful for Jack Jarvis.
That's not making the cut.
My pets.
Dogs, cats?
All of them. Dogs, cats, chickens, bunny.
How many pets do you have?
Too many to count. In the tens.
Wow.
I'm thankful for my family. I have a 1-year-old son. He's doing very well. He's healthy. Friends, and just overall gratitude for life.
All right. Thank you.
Oh, thankful for a lot of things. Friends, families, especially puck season's coming up, so definitely hockey.
Thankful for my friends. I'm thankful for my family. I'm thankful for everyone here. I'm thankful for everyone behind the camera. I'm thankful for my hockey teammates. I'm thankful for the teachers. I'm thankful for the administration. I'm thankful for everyone who's helped me out.
I'm thankful for you guys. We're a great team.
Hey,
great
team. Hey, group hug.
Happy Thanksgiving, AHS.
The AHS seniors played their annual charity football game. Let's check in with them to see how they did.
What team did you guys coach?
The Surfers.
How do you think the game went?
I think the game went very well. I mean, the coaches, we put in a great game plan, and the girls just executed very well.
Who stood out to you guys?
Michaela.
Yeah, Michaela Buckley-Fisher on offense. Ella Vidoni had a great game at quarterback. And then Elise, give it up to Fergie over here. Flip the camera. Fergie, ton of tackles, was all over the defense. She did an amazing job too.
Thank you. What team were you on for the charity football game?
I was a surfer.
How do you think the game went?
It went very well. In the beginning, it was a little bit shaky, but we got it in the second half.
And what was your favorite memory from the game?
Probably when Michaela got a pick six to win it for the game.
Thank you. What team were you on for the charity football game?
I was coaching the Bikers.
How do you think your performance went?
I think it went really good. They were all very coordinated, and they knew what they were doing. So.
And who do you think stood out to you?
I think the main person that stood out was Jack Jarvis because he did a really good flip, but he also had good bases underneath him that threw him really high. So,
thank you. What team were you on for the charity football game?
I was on the Bikers.
And how did the game go?
It went okay. We had some good plays. Our coaches really prepared us in the games.
And what was your favorite memory?
Probably the cheerleaders doing the flip. I think that was really cool, and we definitely did better than the surfers' cheerleading routine.
Thank you.
What are your unpopular opinions, HS?
And what's your unpopular opinion?
I think that pineapple on pizza is fantastic, and it should not be hated on.
Okay, and I agree. So. Is your unpopular opinion apples and cheese?
Because it tastes good, and it has a lot of flavor, like the cheese. You know, it add more flavor in it.
Okay.
Mashed potatoes stink, and they should never be on a Thanksgiving plate, ever.
And why do you think that?
They just suck. Like, why would you eat mashed potatoes with turkey? Like, what's the, like, diversity in the meal? Like, you could do better with that. Like, come on.
Okay. What's your unpopular opinion?
Kraft mac and cheese and ketchup is good.
And why is that?
Just really flavorful. Give it a try.
Okay.
I sleep with socks on.
And why?
Because it's comfortable and I don't want my dogs barking.
Okay.
I hate Taylor Swift.
I can't stand country music.
Oh, that's a good one.
Guys, I don't know.
She doesn't have one.
I don't have a pin.
She's very popular.
Okay, thank you.
Popular opinion is that mashed potatoes is better with a lot of salt and no gravy. I hate gravy.
Okay, and why?
Because gravy is just like, it's like bad. It's like thick and chunky. I don't like it.
Okay, thanks.
My unpopular opinion is that watermelon is the worst fruit.
Why?
It's just disgusting and I don't like it.
I disagree with you. What are your thoughts on someone saying watermelon's the worst fruit?
I agree. I actually don't like watermelon that much.
What? Why?
It's too watery.
What? Yeah, watermelon is the best.
It like doesn't have a taste. I just don't like it.
Okay.
I hate seafood.
I drink straight milk.
And why?
Because it smells. It just tastes good.
Okay.
Do you know how to use a tourniquet? Learn how at the upcoming Stop the Bleed event hosted by the Medical Opportunities Club.
Medical Opportunities Club is hosting a Stop the Bleed event on December 5th during H4 in the cafeteria.
Stop the Bleed is a program that trains and equips people with the knowledge on how to reduce the loss of life due to traumatic bleeding.
You'll be trained in using a tourniquet, making a tourniquet from available materials, stopping the flow of blood, bandaging a wound, and acting fast. We have a team from Lawrence General Hospital that will be coming in to train you all, and they'll be handing out certificates at the end.
Everyone is welcome to attend and no prior experience is needed. Sign up on MyFlix Learning and hope to see you all there.
Time for a new segment on AHS News. Pass the mic.
Today we're going to play a game to get to know people at AHS. We're going to play Pass the Microphone. I'm going to pass the microphone to someone who has a dog.
I'm passing the microphone to someone who plays volleyball.
I'm passing the microphone to someone taller than 6 foot.
I'm passing the microphone to someone who has a pet fish.
I'm passing the microphone to someone whose favorite color is green.
I'm gonna pass the mic to my boy, Mr. Blitzo.
I want to pass the mic to someone who loves Andover High School.
I'm passing the mic to someone who likes iced coffee.
I'm passing the microphone to someone who's been snorkeling in a coral reef.
I'm passing the microphone to someone who's the president of a club.
I'm passing the mic to Mr. Brennan.
I'm Mr. Brennan, and this has been Passing the Mic.
That's all we have for AHS News.
Thanks for watching. We'll see you next H1.